Hello guys, welcome to SWK Tutorials. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create Realistic class, Tinted class, Gradient class, and finally, Textured class. The scene setup is extremely simple. We have some polygon objects in the scene, and as far as lighting is concerned, I have used GI texture for lighting and HDRI map for reflections and refractions. Scene files and HDRI map links are given below in the description. Realistic class. Select the class panel. Right click. Assign new material. And select a basic V-Ray MTL material. Start interactive rendering. Most of the refractive and transparent material have a very dark diffuse color, so set the diffuse color to black. Plus, if you look at the piece of a glass, you would notice a very strong reflection. So, open the reflection rollout and set the reflection color to 230. Dark color means less reflection, while brighter color means more reflection. Example. Black color has no reflections, while white color means full 100% reflection. Make sure use funnel is checked to get the glass look. Currently, there is no transparency or refractions in the glass panel. To make it refractive, open refractions rollout and set the refraction color to 250. And render. Again, black means no refraction, while white means more refraction. Index of refraction or IOR values for glass type is between 1.5 to 1.7. For glass panel, set it to 1.517. For other IOR values, type IOR values in your browser and see the result from there. Oops, one more thing. Set both the refraction and reflection max depth to 10. Click here. Change your max depth to 10 for refraction. Now, open your reflections and change your max depth to 10. In 99% of situations, max depth 10 will make sure that you get the perfect reflection and refraction. If you want to know more about it, then you can watch this tutorial. Now, we have successfully made a clear class. Next, it's extremely simple to make a tinted class. We use the fog color to change the color of the glass panel and fog multiplier to change the strength of the fog color. Change the fog color according to your need, but I will suggest not to use a fully saturated bright color like these. Red, yellow, green, whatever you do. Don't use a fully saturated color, else you might run into trouble. Even if you want a red color, still use a slightly less saturated color like this. And now, Use a fog multiplier to control the strength of the color. Values greater than 1 will increase the strength of the fog color. If I increase it from 1 to 5, you can see that the strength of this fog color has been increased. Let's set it back again to 1. Values lower than 1 will decrease the fog color. 0.5, 0.2, 0.1. That's how we make a realistic tinted glass. Since we know how to add color to our glass panels, now it's time to make some creative gradient glass panels. Click on the fog color settings and add a ramp. Start interactive rendering. Change my fog multiplier to 1. Now, click here, change your color, let's take it to something like this. I can control it like this. You can see the red color is going down towards the white. Plus, I can do it like this too. You can also go with two colors. You can see the colors. Now it's all up to you how you want to use it. You can even change the interpolation type. Let's take it to none and then bring it here. You can see the two colors here. Change your ramp from V to U. Now it's all up to you how you want to use it. The more you know about these ramps, you can easily use it. See, like this. Click here again. We can play with the fog multiplier to control it further. Now we will learn how to use textures in fog colors. First of all, right click on the fog multiplier and click break connection. Next, again click here, click on file and select your texture. Currently, I'm using this texture in this class. I will put its link in the description. Click here. If you want to control the strength of this fog color, then again select your glass panel, go to its material and play with your fog multiplier. If you want to control the texture, then still it's extremely simple. Click here. You just need to know about texturing and unwrapping. Increase it a little bit like this. And guys, you can see how easy we can do this thing. So guys, you have successfully learned how to create realistic glass material, realistic tinted glass material, creative glass materials, and textured glass materials. Before you go, I just want to tell you guys one more thing. If you are using V-Ray 5, you will find this feature only in V-Ray 5. If you are using V-Ray 5, then when you apply the new material, V-Ray MTL material, then you can click on the presets, left click here, and you have all of these materials. You can create a simple glass, architectural glass, frosted tinted glass too. But even if you are creating these things like this tinted glass, to change the glass parameters according to your need, like I want this color to be light, you need to learn these parameters that I have just told you guys. So guys, I hope that this tutorial was helpful for you. If you like this tutorial, give it a like. If you love this tutorial, subscribe to my channel, share my videos. Keep creating guys. Bye bye.